So these are my freshly acquired stepper motors. These are freedom grown Teknic Hudson brushless DC servos with integrated encoders. And if none of that made any sense to you, I'll explain it like this. These motors allow me to move things very quickly and with great precision. Motors like these are used to make machines that carve out tiny details with a spinning cutter. This is called a CNC mill. But mills are so last decade. 3D printing is the new hotness. So instead of making things from solid steel, you can squirt plastic into layers to make, well, mostly just toys. But I want to change that by building my own 3D printer. Controlling these motors is just the first step.
Okay, so we're going to be playing with some Arduinos. I'm reverse engineering this motor control. Off to a good start. The challenge here today is to take this servo motor so that I can start characterizing it on this servo drive board.
So at this point, I'm just feeding 5 volts into the development board from the Arduino. And then I just jumpered 5 volts into the ready and enable pins. It freaking turns. Awesome. So the next thing I'm gonna do is wire up one of these with a bunch of jumpers out of every pin so that it's a little easier for me to troubleshoot here instead of just, you know, counting them out and plugging them in on my 25 pin there.
But before I do that, my girlfriend and I take a quick trip over to Wonder Spaces in downtown. And if you haven't heard of Wonder Spaces before, it's kind of like this interactive art exhibit. And it's really cool. If it comes to your area, I would definitely check it out. Here's some video I took of us while we were there.
Contemplate our homosexuality or lack thereof.
Not flexible anymore. And we return to your regularly scheduled programming.
Hey guys, Future Dane here.
Pastain is a little confused because he hasn't sent the step signal, but the motor is trying to turn anyways. What he doesn't know is that the software on the computer is sending that signal already. Also, because the motor isn't characterized yet, it just spazzes out instead of moving normally. Luckily, I have another motor that is properly configured already.
So this is a little terrifying because it could just slam into the edge, and I'm just going to be ready. Hopefully it doesn't destroy itself. Okay, it's holding position. Let's try moving position. Ooh, I'm scared. Oh, it's perfect. It's just ticking back and forth.
Okay, if you're not all that impressed, I don't really blame you. But this is just the first step in a bigger plan. The next step is running the motor without my PC attached. And I think I have an interesting application for that. If you're not already subscribed, you're going to want to see where I'm going with this, so go ahead and G84 that subscribe button. If you have friends that are struggling with stepper motors like I did, share this video with them. It might help them out.
Thanks for watching, guys.